And so many things has held us down, but now it looks like things are finally coming around. I know we've got a long, long way to go, and where we'll end up, I don't know. But we won't let nothing hold us back. We're putting ourselves together, we're polishing up our act. If you've never been held down before, I know you refuse to be held down anymore. Well,
don't you let nothing, nothing stand in your way. I want you to listen, listen to every word I say, every word I say.
Ain't no stopping us now.
We're on the move.
Psalm 23 from verse 1. Let me read it from this translation. Look into your own. The Lord is my shepherd, to feed, guide, and shield me. I shall not lack. He makes me lie down in fresh, tender, green pastures. He leads me beside the still and restful waters. He refreshes and restores my soul, my life. He leads me in the paths of righteousness, uprightness, and right standing with him, not for my earning it, but for his name's sake. Yes, though I walk through the deep, sunless valley of the shadow of death, I will fear or dread no evil, for you are with me, your rod to protect and your staff to guide. They comfort me. Hallelujah. You may be seated in the Holy Ghost. Everybody, come on. I said to you alone, be with him. Speak to me, and through me speak to your children. Then everyone I shall speak, minister grace and life to the hearers. Do something for us which no man can do. In Jesus' mighty name. And everybody say amen. I said, everybody shout a big amen. Let the Bible say, let them that love the face of God shout. How many of you love the face of God? Lift your voice and shout. Hallelujah. Amen and amen. The Bible said that the power to put to death and put to life is in the tongue, and a man's belly shall be satisfied by the fruits of his lips. Your tongue and your lips are in your mouth. So if the devil takes your mouth, your lips will close, your tongue will close. That's why I said to you, let no man take your mouth from you, because when your mouth closes, your destiny closes. So I said, Lord, my mouth will not close, and because my mouth will not close, my destiny cannot be shut down. No man can shut down my destiny. While the demon was threatening my life, I opened my mouth and said, you cannot take my life. And I was speaking in tongues. I began to shout in my room. Even I had all of them were in the room. And when the demon came, he said, he's going to take somebody's life. If he cannot take me, he will take somebody. I said, even the mosquito in my house is insured. You cannot take my life. And I began to pray. As I was praying and shouting, the unclean spirit increased his troubles. And right there, he wanted to move from the door. I said, you can't move from the door. He must pass through the window, because you're a thief. You enter from the window, he must go through the window. While I was commanding him to leave, 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 I told people in the room, I said, run, everybody leave the room. They were angry. They didn't want to go because they loved their pastor. While I was shouting, get out of my room. Get out, you unclean. I couldn't stand, I couldn't see, I couldn't hear. But my mouth was open. I refused to close my mouth. I opened my mouth wide and I shouted at that place. As the demon said, go from the window. As he was going, the windows began to break into pieces. Physically, people saw it. And right there, 8 bullets were shot and the pellets fell on my window. Why? The Bible said that even though I walk in the shadows of death, there are many more that have seen a shadow and they have stroke. Some have seen shadow and they fainted. Some saw something move around them and they died. Many people have been killed by shadows. Shadows of accident. Shadows of hunger. Shadows of disappointment. Shadows of failure. Shadows of frustration. Every time of your life, you keep seeing shadows that tells you you may lose your job. Shadows that may threaten you. When they say they are coming to audit you, then fear comes. Shadow is coming. When a letter comes, they say there's an embargo. They are going to sack some job people in the offices. That's a shadow. Then you become afraid of the shadows. When you come, you want to go back to the village and somebody sent the letter that your uncle died, your sister died, somebody threatened your life, it is a shadow. So many people have been killed by shadows. But ladies and gentlemen, you shall not be killed by any shadow. No shadow can kill you. I said no shadow can kill you. The man threatening your life is a shadow. The woman threatening your destiny is a shadow. Somebody died in your house last year. This year they died. Next week they died. Last week they died. There are shadows of death. People are dying around your house, around your village. Armed robbers are moving from one house to the other. And your friend called and said, hey, can you see what is happening? Armed robbers said, that is a shadow. But David said, even though I walk, even though I walk, the Lord is my shepherd, I shall not walk. And he said, even though I walk in the shadows of death, I shall not fear any evil. Ladies and gentlemen, don't let shadows kill you. Are you hearing me, friend? Don't die because of a shadow. The shadow of a witch man in your village who threatened you. He came and poured some libation in front of your house. It's a shadow. Shadow. That uncle that came to kill me in my room was a shadow of death. But I walked through that shadow of death. I feared no evil because the Lord is with me. The reason why you should not be afraid is because the Lord is with you. The Lord is with you. And it pains me that it is only the shadow that is killing them. Shadow. That's why a shadow of somebody fear. You fall down and slump. And paralysis starts, stroke. They say something just moved. Something just moved. And people are coming, look, what is in the way move? I just saw a snake. Even people who run mad, it is shadow that makes them to run mad. You are afraid. You say, I saw a lion. I saw a lion. He just passed. Lion, you're living in a place that there is no bush. You're living in not in the village, but you saw a lion in your parlor. Are you listening to me? Every projection of lion and snake you see is a shadow from the witchcraft world. Shadow. And listen to me. The shadow is not the real thing. That's why it's mangled with people. You saw a shadow and you died. What about if the real thing comes? What will happen to you? David said, even though I walk in the shadows of intimidation. Intimidation is a shadow. Threat upon your life is a shadow. Threat upon your marriage is a shadow. Threat upon your business is a shadow. Threat upon your father's life is a shadow. Threat upon your mother's life against your academic status is a shadow. Threat that I will throw you out of the house you don't have to. It's a shadow. It is not the real thing. Don't let shadows kill you. David said, even though I walked in the shadows of death, in the shadows of death, every shadow of death that has harassed your destiny, harassed your life, harassed your health by doctor's report, by lab test, I command that shadow to be destroyed. I destroy that shadow. Even though I walk in the shadows of death, I shall fear no evil. Made that statement when he was walking in the valley of Engedi. He was crossing Engedi. And his master was after his life. And he didn't know what to do. Then he saw a valley. And he was on the plain land. But the master's soldiers were after him. The troops were after him. They said, hey, we don't catch him. As we catch him, that's the end of it. He cannot jump inside that valley.
because there is snake there. Because in that valley is gully, erosions. You see snakes, you see lions, you see all kind of pussycats, and all you saw is a small tunnel of the cat eyes. And David said, I will not stand there and carry me. I know that the Lord is with me. I am moving into that shadow now. He entered that shadow. He jumped inside where there are snakes. As he entered, the snakes all took off. The lions took off. Death took off. Because the shadows of death were there. And when the people came there, they said, hey, look at him. He has committed suicide. He jumped inside the shadow. Why? Because he knows that the Lord is with him. Don't let them drive you out of your village by threat, called shadow. If you enter, you die. They told my son's father, the father who had the land, and the land belongs to them, and an uncle began to take the land from them. And when the villagers came and said, the land belongs to the father, and you know what? The uncle said, okay, nobody will live in that house. And his father began to build and died. His younger brother began to build and died. His mother continued, he died. And everybody in the family ran away. Why? Shadows of death. He went to Abba and saw the same man that threatened his father, and all of them died. He saw in the person's eyes, he took grace and ran away because shadow was there. Every witchcraft threat on your life, libations, traps, set, I declare them shadows. They shall not tamper with your destiny. You will not die. You will live in that house. You will marry that man. You will marry that woman. You will pass your exam. You will get that job. They will not fire you. You will not die in promotion. You will not die in childbearing. If you become pregnant, you will not die. If you are afraid of marriage, they say if you marry, you will die. You will not die. Get married. That threat is a shadow. Jump inside the shadow. The shadow will disappear. I said, jump inside the shadow. The shadow will disappear. The shadows of death. The shadows of sorrow. The shadows of pain. The shadows of crisis. The shadows of late marriage. The shadows of barrenness. The shadows of miscarriage. I said, they shall not touch you. They shall not tamper with your life. Even though I walk in the shadows of death. Plan to go to the village again because of a threat. Go now. No shaking. Nothing happened to you. As you enter your father's house this period, the man will be buried before January. I prophesy that every shadow against your life, every shadow, that thing that casted that shadow. Listen. Something always casts a shadow. Am I right? Whatever that has cast a shadow that threatened your destiny, threatened your marriage, threatened your business, threatened your health, today I destroy that thing that has that shadow. I command it to be destroyed. I say, let it be destroyed. Let it be destroyed in the name of Jesus. Even though I walk in the shadows of death, it is not death, but it is the shadow of death. I said, it's not death, but it is the shadows of death. It is not poison, but it is the shadows of poison. It's not armed robbers, but it is the shadows of armed robbers. It is not lack, but it is the shadows of lack. It's not disease. Symptom is a shadow, but it is the shadow of diseases. It's not death. It's not premature death. It's not suicide. It's not murder. It's not kidnappers. It's not assassins. Many shadows that maybe not to go to their village. Shadows that were cast by kidnappers. Shadows that were cast by Boko Haram. You refuse to go and do a contract in the north because the Boko Haram shadow is everywhere. I say to you, in the name that is above every other name, the Lord is with you. I shall not want. The Lord is with you. Don't be afraid. Don't be dead. Don't feel any dread. Why? The Lord is with you. He said, lo, I am with you even to the end of the world. Shadows. No more shadows. No more what? Shadows. and we're going to have a sticker titled "No More Shadows." The Lord told me, while my son finished talking with me, telling me how the father died, the mother died, and everything, he said, "Go and tell the church that the coming season, no more shadows." You have a project, and lack of money is threatening your life. Shadow. Shadow. That person in your office that is always, each time you see him, your heart begin to beat, is a shadow. It's a shadow of death. It's a shadow of heart attack. It's a shadow of high blood pressure. Shadow. It was a shadow. Every time you take needle and you're checking your blood sugar, and you see soul sugar, is the shadow. Shadow. No more shadows. No more shadows. Even though you walk in the valley, the problem is that you have never walked in the valley. You decide to walk on the plain ground. You don't want to go to the valley. Your safety is in the valley. It is in the valley that you see Lily. How can you prove that God is with you if you have never gone into the shadow? When you don't take risk, you are in the shadow. You are afraid of shadows. Even though I walk in the shadows of death, I shall fear no evil. Why? The Lord is with me. Thy rod and thy staff, they do what? They comfort me. Whenever the sheep is eating grass, it's eating grass, and the lion is coming, David knows what it is. The lion is coming. The sheep, when the sheep looks around and see that the shepherd is there, he continues eating his grass. Because you know that the shepherd is there, and that the sheep cannot kill him because the shepherd is around. They will see great 20 lions coming. They see him, look at him. He has the rod, he has a staff. He'll be eating. Why? The shepherd is with them. I want you to know that you should go home and enjoy your life. Why? The shepherd is with you. Walk with this understanding. If you're entering a car and there's a, you saw 10 accidents on the road, don't be afraid, because what? Look around you. Is he with me? Yes, the shepherd is with me. So why should I be afraid? The reason why you are afraid of taking your children to good school is that you don't know that the shepherd is with you. You're not thinking about driving a good car because you don't know that the shepherd is with you. You're so scared. And if you start foundation of house in the village, that you will die because you don't know the abiding presence of the Lord. You are a container of the shepherd. When the lion makes a mistake and comes to attack the sheep, the shepherd comes. David comes and slays them. The man knows that it is not the sword of Saul that can give him victory. It's not the armor of Saul, but it's the Lord. All he was waiting for Saul to say is, "The Lord is go with you. Go and build." He said, "We're not going except your presence goes with us." Always get his presence. When the light comes, when you face the sun, your shadow will be behind you. Am I right? You cannot be facing the light and your shadow will be in front of you. Everything that is attacking your destiny, face the light, it will go behind you. School fees, house rent, your health, everything that is troubling your life, face the light. What did I say? Face the light. When you face the light, what happens? The shadow goes behind. I see the shadow behind you. I see the shadow behind you. And when your shadow goes behind, it kills those who are pursuing you. Even though I walk. You see, the reason why you don't know the power of the shepherd is that you have not tried to shepherd anybody as a child of God. You've not shepherded anybody. There's no one you have ever followed up in your life. You have not fasted and be praying for somebody. So David understands the power of a shepherd because he was a shepherd before he became a king. It is your caring for people that raises confidence in your heart that God is in charge. Hello? Can you imagine my children running around looking for food when I'm around? Is it possible? Can you imagine my children hiding under the bed when I'm around? Maybe there's a knock at the door. Boo, 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 boo. They can't hide under the bed. They will stay behind me. The shepherd is there. Whenever trouble knocks at your door, the shepherd comes in front to confront the problems. I release your shepherd today. I release inside the consciousness of your shepherd. Even though I walk, that is, even if that, what is that? Even though he said, if I intentionally enter into trouble, the man is there to bring me out. Even though I make that mistake, the Lord is there with me. Even though I walk in the shadows of death, I shall fear no evil. For the Lord is with me. Stand on your feet. Just begin to talk to God. Touch me one more time. Oh, touch me.
Thank you for watching today's telecast. Join us next week at Resurrection First Ministries, Beautiful Gate Assembly, 11 Omokwa Street, behind ESBS TV, Enugu. For prayers and counseling, call 080-378-38933.
There's been so many things that's held us down.